Hi. Let's take a look at a common application of quantum mechanics that we need to do every time we deal with any new quantum system. And that is what we call normalizing the wave function. And then once we have a normalized wave function, we'll be able to use that to calculate expectation values. Now, normalize just means if we're looking at a probability, then we have a 100% chance of seeing something happen over all of space. So mathematically, if you have a probability wave function, like say psi as a function of position equal to some constant a times Euler's number to the minus a times x squared, now as x goes to infinity, this goes to zero pretty quickly, e to the x squared. As x goes to negative infinity, this goes to zero pretty quickly. So because on both ends we have a function that's heading towards zero, then we should end up getting a finite integral if we go to calculate the integral of the magnitude of this. Now, for most quantum wave functions, most probability waves, they have complex dependence. They depend on the square root of negative one. This function doesn't. So its complex conjugate is exactly the same thing. So to normalize, we take the complex conjugate, multiply by our original probability wave function, and then we integrate over the entire region of space that that wave function occupies. So here we'd be going from minus infinity to infinity of a e to the minus a x squared times a e to the minus a x squared integrated with respect to dx, and we'd set that equal to 1. Well, that becomes an integral from minus infinity to infinity of a squared, which is a constant, which can be brought outside, times e to the minus 2a x squared dx. And that's still set equal to 1. Now, this integral has a special name, sort of. This is a doubling of what's known as Gauss's probability integral. And this is also known as a Gaussian wave function. So Gauss's probability integral says if you calculate from 0 to infinity the integral of e to the minus a constant alpha times x squared with respect to dx, the value is going to be 1/2 times the square root of pi divided by that constant alpha. So here, our constant alpha is 2a. And you might say, well, this is 0 to infinity, but this is minus infinity to infinity. Well, for this integral, our function is symmetric if we take a look at the behavior towards positive infinity compared to the behavior towards negative infinity. Both of those limits should behave and look exactly the same. So if we look at half the integral, our total integral would just be twice that. So our integral is going to be equal to a squared times the square root of pi divided by 2 times little a. So solving for my constant capital a would be 2 over pi quantity raised to the 1/4 power, the square root of the square root of 2a over pi. Now, once we have that constant, we would properly write our wave function as being psi of x is 2a over pi to the 1/4 power times e to the minus ax squared. Well, an expectation is just a really fancy way of saying we're going to be calculating an average. And the way that you calculate averages or expectations in quantum mechanics is you would take either side of our probability wave, either the probability wave itself and the complex conjugate, and you would sandwich whatever it is you're averaging in between the two. And we would write it out as the complex conjugate of our wave function times what we're averaging. So if we want to find the average location, it would just be x times our original wave function dx. Now, because this has no complex dependence, I can just rewrite things, and I would end up with x times a squared, which would give me the square root of pi over, not pi over 2a, it would be the square root of 2a over pi. E to the minus 2ax squared dx. And if I were to evaluate this integral, that constant just gets pulled out of the front, and x e to the minus a constant times x squared is something that evaluates to a constant, just like the basic Gauss's probability integral. However, with that factor of x out in front, our behavior as we go to positive infinity is exactly the inverse of the behavior as it goes to minus infinity. So if we were to break this integral in two parts, the result that we get going from 0 to plus infinity is equal to minus the result that we get going from minus infinity to 0. So our expectation calculates out to 0. Which, if you've seen a Gaussian function that's centered at x equals 0, we would totally expect that the average of that function to be at the center, which is 0. Thanks for watching.